Guys, here we are again with another Go Kids game. Oh boy. Okay, so you guys know this game, okay? This is the sweets and cream face with your face in it. That's what we call it in Go Kids, don't we, okay? So as you guys know, okay, I've not put too many sweets in here because, I mean, I just thought, I only need a few because I'm only going to have 30 seconds anyway, okay? You guys have to keep count for me, okay? So what I'm going to do is I've got this plate of sweets, right, okay? Oh, with the love heart ones. You guys know that's my favorite, and if you watch the video from 2 or 3 weeks ago, you know why, okay? And I'm going to basically cover it and smother it in this real dairy squirty cream, okay? So I have 30 seconds to get as many sweets underneath this cream from here, from this plate over here, to this little lid over here, okay? So I'm gonna shake it with the lid off. Here we go. Okay, right. I'm gonna smother it. Are you ready? So count me down, not for the actual thingy, but just count me down 3, 2, 1, just for this, okay? So 3, 2, 1. Oh, Father help me. Father help me. Oh, can I keep going? Woo! Oh, Father. This game. Now you got it, boy. Okay, right. But you know what I'm gonna do? I might just have to do one of these situations over here. If you're doing restaurants, to make sure you're getting that cold. Right, okay. Right, I need another countdown, guys. Okay, I have 30 seconds to get as many sweets as I can from this plate onto here. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
What? Oh, it's so far.
1.
I don't like this. 1. 3.
I did eight. I think that's well. Oh, I don't care what the time is anymore, guys. But that's okay.
Nine.
Okay, I cheated. I'm sorry, I had to. But 9. Let me go for 10. 10.
Now you got it, boy.
10. Yes, I did it. 10. Okay. So, I'm going to go and clean myself up now. See you guys in a bit.
2 hours later.
Wow. What a game, right? What a messy game. Now, the only thing that was missing whilst I was playing that game all by myself, I know you guys were with me through this video, but all that was missing was having you guys here with me, cheering me on, but most of all, having you guys do it, so I don't have to, okay? But it was good fun. Anyway, it was all good fun. But yeah, welcome to this week's Go Kids video. What a way to start off this week's video. What a way to start off, and I'm so, literally, I'm like, I don't think I like cream, you know? After all that, I do not think I like cream. I still feel like I've got creams somewhere on my face, and I can still smell it as well. Anyway, it was all in good fun. I hope you guys have had an amazing week. What have you been up to? What have you been getting up to? How has school been online? How has school been for those of you that have gotten to go to school physically because your parents are key workers? How has it been? Good? Amazing? We're blessed? Yes, we are blessed. We are blessed and highly favored. Amen. Okay, so before we go any further, here is a quick recap of what we talked about last week. Awesome stuff. Awesome. Okay, so quick one. Hands up if you are a new creation in Christ Jesus. Yes. Amen. Hands up if you are an old creation in Christ Jesus. Oh, no, that's none of us. Okay. Oh, I tricked you there. Okay. Right. Hands up if you're sat on the big chair with Jesus. Yes, that is all of us. Yes, we are sat in heavenly realms with Jesus, okay? We're sat right next to Jesus in heavenly realms, and we have a big chair, just like Jesus has a big chair, okay? We have a big chair too. Amazing, okay? So that means we have a new position. And like I spoke about last week, that gives us power and authority to walk in this life, okay? Using the power of God inside of us and using the authority that we have in Jesus' name, okay? So today, I want to talk to us about having right standing with God. Everyone say right standing with me. 1, 2, 3, go. Say right standing. Amen. Okay. What does that mean? What does right standing mean? Well, right standing means that we're righteous. Okay. We are righteous because of what Jesus did on the cross. Okay. And because we're sat with him, with Jesus in heavenly realms, that means we're righteous, okay? The position we now have in Christ Jesus means that we have right standing with God, okay? So let's get our Bibles and let's go to our key verse for today, okay? Let's go to our key verse today. Everyone got their Bibles? Yes? Wave it up in the air. If it's a phone, that's fine. If it's a tablet, that's fine. Wave it up in the air. Amen, amen, amen. I love this Bible, okay? But I might use it a bit later. I'm not sure yet, okay? But let's open our Bibles to Romans chapter 5, verses 1, okay? That's Romans chapter 5, verses 1. Are you there? Are you there? If you're not there, hurry up then. I've not got all day. I'm joking. Okay, if you're at Romans chapter 5, verse 1, let me hear you say hallelujah. Amen, amen. And if you're not quite there yet, it's fine. I'll let you catch up. Okay, so it says, therefore, since we have been made right in God's sight by faith, we have peace with God because of what Jesus Christ our Lord has done for us. Okay, I'm going to read it again. Therefore, since we have been made right in God's sight by faith, we have peace with God because of what Jesus Christ our Lord has done for us. And what has Jesus Christ done for us? Let me hear you. You know this? Yes, he died on the cross for us with all of our sins. Okay, everything we've ever done wrong, everything we could ever do wrong, Jesus took it upon himself and he died on the cross for us, okay? And then he rose again victorious, having defeated sin and having defeated the kingdom of darkness. Isn't that amazing, okay? But Jesus doing that for us means one thing and one thing only. It means what? Can you guys guess? It means we are now, okay, these look nothing like any of us, and this looks nothing like God, but I want you guys to imagine this is God, okay? Just imagine, use your imagination, okay? Again, it looks nothing like God, okay, but use your imagination. This is God and this is us, okay? So Jesus dying on the cross meant what? So God is over here and we are over here. So what's happening? We are, there's a bit of a distance, isn't there? Actually, I'm gonna make it bigger. There's a wide distance, okay? So we were once separated from God, okay? Because we were born into sin, right? Because of what Adam did. Okay, sin was introduced into the world, right? So because of that, we were separated from God. But because of what Jesus Christ did on the cross for us, what did that do? It brought us back together with God, okay? Because this is what God intended from the beginning. If you think about Genesis, right at the beginning, when God created, you know, God created Adam, right? And what did Adam and God do? They spent time together. Do you know that Adam and God actually spent time together in the garden? They actually spent time together. Like Adam was walking with God and chatting to him, and they were chilling. They were best mates. Okay, they were best mates. They were this close. But when Adam and Eve sinned, what happened? That separation happened, okay? And that meant that all of us that were born, we were then separated from God. But once we receive Jesus into our hearts, once we repent and we call Jesus our Lord and Savior, we're now reconciled with God, okay? The Bible uses the word reconciled, which means we're joined together again with God, okay? We're now joined with God again. We're brought back together with God. Isn't that amazing? Okay, and that's what it means. So when we're talking about sitting on the big chair and having power and authority, that means we are righteous before God. And that's what righteousness means, basically. Righteousness basically means to stand in the presence of God with no sense of sin or guilt, right? You know, sometimes, I hope this isn't the case for you guys, but you know, when you're called into the head teacher's office, right? You know you've done something bad, right? You know you've done something really bad, and you're called into the head teacher's office or teacher's office, or you have a detention, right? Maybe not you, okay, if you can't relate because you're good at two shoes, amen, praise God. Okay, but for example, I remember, I think I've shared this story with you guys, because I remember when I did something really, really naughty in school. I did something really, 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 really naughty. Should I say this again? Okay, I'm just gonna say it again, okay? Because God loves me and I've repented, okay? I accidentally cut a girl's hair. It was like, her hair was this long. And we were playing about in art. And I was like, da, da, da. And I literally cut her hair over there. And this huge, massive chunk of hair got cut off. It was so bad. I felt so bad. But I knew I'd done something wrong. So when I was sent to the head teacher's office, right? Literally, I went in, like, I remember the image of me not being able to look at the head teacher because I knew I'd done something wrong and I felt so bad. I felt so guilty in my heart that I couldn't look at the head teacher. I was just like, oh, I felt terrible, you know, because I knew what I did was so wrong and I knew that I was going to get into trouble. So I couldn't look my head teacher in the eye, okay? And living in sin, right, which is doing what doesn't please God and going against God's will, okay, doing wrong things, okay, that sometimes makes us feel guilty. But because of what Jesus has done on the cross of Calvary, it means that we can stand before God with no sense of sin, with no sense of guilt. We don't have to feel guilty anymore because Jesus paid the price for all of our sins, okay? So Jesus took care of all of our sins, all of our guilt on the cross. Okay, so when we do something wrong, when we sin, we repent. Because remember, no, Jesus has died, you know, for me. Jesus has saved me from that, okay? So our attitude starts to change. And when we repent, what does it mean? It means to go in another direction. It means to change our mind and say, I don't live like that anymore. I don't do that anymore. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. It means I have right standing with God because of what Jesus did on the cross, okay? Now, do you guys remember a few weeks ago when I put all the sins as post-it notes on my body, right? Yeah, you guys remember, and all these sins were on there, right? And we're talking about Jesus, right, being the righteousness that covers us, right? Do you remember? Well, I'm gonna jog your memory. Let's open our Bibles to Isaiah 61 verse 10. Isaiah 61 verse 10, okay? It says, I am overwhelmed with joy in the Lord my God, for he has dressed me with the clothing of salvation and draped me in a robe of righteousness, okay? So Jesus took away our sins, all our filthy clothes that were basically full of sins, okay? Spiritually, he took it away, okay? He took it away and nailed them on the cross. And then he clothed us, he put on us a robe of righteousness to say, we are now loved by God. Okay, that as we accept Jesus into our hearts and we choose to follow Jesus and we choose to make Jesus our Lord and Savior, right? That means that we're righteous in Jesus, okay? So no longer do we have to stand before God all guilty and say, I'm not perfect. No, you're not perfect. But guess who is perfect? Jesus is perfect. And Jesus is in you and you are in him, okay? Therefore, you can sit on that big chair, okay, with confidence. Always remember that, okay, as you're walking through life, remember that you are positioned right next to Jesus in heavenly realms, okay? So sin can't take over you. Sickness can't take over you. The devil himself can't take over you because you are seated with Jesus in heavenly realms, okay? And you are the righteousness of God in Christ. Isn't that amazing? I think that's awesome. So no longer are we separated, okay, from God. We have right standing with God. We are joined together again with God. We are now one with God because of what Jesus Christ did on the cross for us. And I think that's amazing. And I think that deserves a shout of hallelujah. Okay, so don't forget to meditate and pray on our key verse for today, which is Romans chapter 5, verses 1. That's Romans chapter 5, verses 1, which says, therefore, since we have been made right in God's sight by faith, we have peace with God because of what Jesus Christ, our Lord, has done for us. Okay, that should put a massive smile on your face, like it puts a smile on my face, okay? Because that's worth rejoicing over, okay? So thank you guys so much for joining me today. Thank you for joining me with Praise Time. Thank you for joining me with a Game Time. I'm sure you guys were rooting me on. Because I think I did quite well, okay? And I hope that you guys have a blessed week. I'm speaking, the Spirit of God follows you, guides you, leads you, comforts you in all that you do in the name of Jesus. And the revelation of what Jesus Christ did for you on the cross continues to live with you every single day from the moment you wake up to the moment you sleep and in your dreams as well. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. So God bless you. God keep you. And always remember that God has made you the very best. See ya.